In the last lesson, we talked about the lay down to the target. Well, we're going to expand it a little bit farther, make the picture even a little brighter here. So we're going to go from lay down to target to break point. And this is important because it actually changes the shape of your shot. So today we're going to talk about these three lines out here, and literally we've got three very different shapes here.
Yeah, you know, what you want to do is look at how we have these lines taped, and they're all going over the second arrow. You can actually use the same target 15 feet down the lane in an infinite number of ways, really. We only have three lines taped here, but you can kind of visualize the second arrow as being a swivel point. And you change the angle of your shot and the shape of your shot simply by moving your foot distance left to right on the approach and changing your laydown point on the line.
It's important, too, because the second arrow sometimes plays very straight. They may be a little slick, and you have to play pretty direct up the second arrow. And when you play that line just straight, the headline from lay down to target is straight up the same board, that would be the purple line here. And you can see that line actually goes straight up the lane for a little while. Now, if the lanes were actually slicker than that and you still wanted to play the second arrow, what might you do? If they were slicker, you'd probably...
if they're slicker, then you want to move right and you want to point the ball a little bit more. So you could actually move over. Here we have a lay down point of 7. And we're still using the second arrow, but now we're going right to left off our hand because the lanes are so slick. So you're going to close your body angle a little bit and actually point the ball more using the same target, but you're changing the ball shape and the ball path dramatically just by changing your laydown point.
And that's really, really important because there are some times that that's necessary to score well. And the opposite is true, too. If the lanes are exceptionally dry and you still need to play the second arrow, then you're going to have to move again. Which way would you move then?
You'd move left then. And obviously, we're going to make our laydown point left of that purple line where the red line is, or 13. And that simple three-board move there at the laydown point makes a dramatic difference. You can see going down the lane. It changes direction quite a bit going down the lane. But if that's what the lanes call for that night, that's what you have to do.
And that's what it's all about at this level. When you start to get better and your scores get better, you need to have versatility in how you think the game. There are no rules. When you play the second arrow, it doesn't mean you always stand in the same spot.
Right.
You have to get comfortable about moving around and just get comfortable with it.
Yeah, there's two things here. You know, we talked in previous lessons, and we'll continue to talk about, where we actually move you around and have you play different parts of the lane, even at the arrows. Play the first arrow, play the fourth arrow. But as you can see, you can make quite a bit of difference and how your ball reacts and what part of the lane you're playing simply by using one target as a swivel point. So these are three dramatically different lines, even if you stay with the same eye target.
Yeah, and so that's our challenge for you. In your next practice session, go out and use the second arrow, but I want you to test it, and I want you to go straight up the second arrow, then I want you to go from left to right at the second arrow, and then I want you to go from right to left at the second arrow, and see how good you can get. And remember, there are no rules. You're on your way to having some great scores and having a lot of fun.